My name is Maurice Dupre. I'm a citizen of St. Catherine Parish since 1984. I have a PhD in mathematics from the University of Pennsylvania. I've been a member of the American Mathematical Society for over 40 years, a member of the North American Society of Research Science for all of us, 40 years, and a faculty member of Tulane University for over 40 years. And I have to say, when it comes to this hydraulic fracturing, government accounting office report in June of this year reported that over 2 billion gallons of toxic wastewater are being ejected from waste storage for hydraulic fracturing every day, nationwide. So what we're talking about here in St. Catherine Parish is health, making this beautiful presentation. It's sort of like a drug deal when it says the first of the street. The cattle will get another level of tent, and once it does, we'll have industrialization to the tune of what the government accounting office reports. But let's look at some more numbers. Recently, the CEO of Halliburton announced that its shareholders that the new well completion techniques would require 75 car loads of sand as opposed to just 20 car loads of sand. In other words, we're talking about 4 times as much. If you look at the U.S. Geological Survey of Friction Hydraulic Fracturing, it says it requires 2 to 6 million gallons of frac fluid, but a larger field of 15 million. Well, if you take 15 million and multiply it by 4, which Halliburton wants to do, you get 60 million gallons. And by George, the largest frack well completion job has recently surpassed 60 million gallons. It makes economic sense. Hydraulic fracturing is basically underground strip mining. It doesn't make economic sense to have a warm hydraulic frack well. So in order to get the most out of their mineral leases, we're going to have many, many wells, and we could see something like 1,000 of St. Catherine Parish. Now, if you take that 720 billion gallons of waste that's injected every year, according to the government accounting report, and multiply that by 4, that gets you up to over 2.8 trillion gallons. Now, 2.4 trillion gallons is about the volume of water in Lake Pontchartrain. So we can throw in probably Lake Maurepas as well. The idea of any industry can safely handle trucking around here and there, injecting it in the storage wells or hydraulic fracturing operations, that volume of fluid logic. So, on that basis alone, what that is to say, this is a very bad thing to get into around any residential areas. Up there in the bottom of the shale, we're not really in the middle of nowhere. Here we have a residential area, 240,000. The appraised, the assessed value of the property in St. Catherine Parish is $2.2 billion. That means the actual value is between $15 and $22 billion. Peer-reviewed papers in academic journals show that the value could go down by 30%. The mineral, people who get money from the lease, they'll be gained by 11% overall. But we're talking about giving $2.2 billion to a very few people so that everybody 5 watts loses between 4.4